Well, hello, there is another update on this 5-gallon cosmic blue tetra thing. So, first of all, let's talk about this Hygrophila Corymbosa plant. I like it very much. It's light, the stem is very strong. And, you know, in general, you see, I like this plant because it's low maintenance, requires no CO2, and has a very high growth rate and everything. But yesterday I had a lot of problems while planting it, and the reason for it is that this aquarium actually has no nutritious substrate, and this can barely call the substrate. These are rather large fraction stones, and you know, back in the day there were no rooted plants, to be honest. And only Vallisneria, and Vallisneria somehow, I don't know the reason, it felt really good in this substrate. And there is just a thin layer of it just on the bottom. And that's why I used it, you know, for this aquarium for a long period of time. And we had a lot of Vallisneria here. It just died because of the hydrochloroquine that I, you know, used to treat my fish from ick. And, you know, I deprived the tank from the sunlight, deprived of the sunlight for like 2 days, and, you know, the Vallisneria died. And also maybe chemicals from the medicine also contributed to melting of this Vallisneria. So these are new Vallisneria shoots, you know. Well, you see, guppies, they are just, I don't know what they are doing. This is a female and this is the male, and they have some dancing and everything. So, well, cosmic blue tetras, what I did, I added some more substrate, which is more appropriate for planting of plants. And I planted this guy, which is Lobelia, the same species that, you know, is planted in 7-gallon. And I had one left, and I decided why not to put it here. And this, you know, Hygrophila Corymbosa. So there is a hill actually behind the stone, the hill of gravel, and it sits in here. So, well, this plant is easy to be propagated. You just cut it, you know, cut apart, remove the bottom leaves, and plant it. But so far it is not that you know, tall to be cut. So, well, I'm just waiting for it to settle. Well, that's it. And there is the sort of road, you know, of this more appropriate gravel between these two parts. I didn't want to remove all the gravel because there will be a huge loss of beneficial bacteria, obviously. So, but I like the design. It looks really nice. The design is kind of like, you know, many hobbyists do, having two different types of substrate. Well, that's it. And this is a thicker, you know, layer of this gravel. This is more, you know, comfortable and more convenient for planting. I just don't replant this, you know, these plants, especially this cryptocoryne, because somehow they've always felt very good in this stone substrate. I don't know why, you know, because this is not the first time I plant crypt in here. As I remember, I had smaller one, which is in another tank right now, which also grew nicely in this exact, you know, substrate. So, that's it, and we'll see. We'll see. I mean, like, I'm keeping an eye on everything here, you know, guppies all around, and waiting for maybe fry after some time, I don't know. And there is a filter, as you can see, external filter running. Also, I have an air pump, which I run in the morning and in the evening, not all the time. So, well, that's it for today. Thank you for joining, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.